Okay, guys, I'm here to talk to you about sterilizing, because by now most of us do have masks and filters. I posted plenty of videos on my own channel, how to do, what can be, how to make those masks, sewing, not sewing, which filter acceptable, which one is not. But now we all facing a dilemma, how to sterilize all that, because this virus is a strain of virus which is humanity never know before. No, well, that's why I want to talk to you about it. Who am I to talk to you about sterilization? Look up my channel. It's supposed to be used for teaching sewing, styling, but became all about surviving only 2 weeks after I uploaded my first video because pandemic started. So you will say, seamstress talking about sterilizing now. Does a seamstress can be know anything about it, right? Well, first of all, I had that word seamstress. It's like, I don't understand some English words. This is one of them, such as seamstress. What I supposed to be stressed about seams? I prefer word tailor. And tailor is a skilled and educated job. And plus, I only become tailor being in immigration. Before immigration, I had different professions and different education, plenty of it. And anybody who got any education at all first learned how to do own research. And it stay with you for life, unless you never paid enough attention to your education. So now I found myself a situation when my business closed and I have plenty of time on my hands and desire to help others who still working, who don't have the time or desire to search all about this virus. And I invest myself in this research. Already tried to come up with some sterilizing suggestions about what to do for mask, for filters, but I did fail you. I have to admit I did fail you. I deleted that video because, again, it's just a too huge problem for us as regular people to come up with intelligent decisions about it. I wish CDS will come with very clear instructions for all of us and publish it, what we will not rack our brains anymore, how to do all that, but they do not. No, well, that is I'm come up with this video as a result of 3 weeks of my studies, what I want to share with you. And I think it's end of this, my ideas about sterilization, because I spent already too much time on it. I put it on paper like that, because if I mispronounce some words, say something wrong, at least you know, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. Or you're just confused by my fast talking. Again, let's look at it. Six known ways of sterilization. It's alcohol, dry heat, steam, UV, boiling, and bleach. Well, let's just go through all of them. So far, what I know about alcohol. Well, we're going to talk about sterilization on masks and filters on both. And what about alcohol? What about using alcohol for that? Coronavirus, usually people call it COVID-19 virus. COVID-19, it's a sickness. It's a sickness caused by coronavirus. It's not coronavirus by itself. Coronavirus is a type of SARS viruses. And do become deactivated in 60% of concentration of alcohol in distilled water, meaning if we can buy from store a retail bottle of alcohol with 120 proof divided on two, that will show us exactly percent of alcohol in that distilled water. And of course, where we gonna get that kind of bottle, 120 proof? I believe only like two states allowed to say it, to sell it, and I believe it's all gone from shelves. No, well, alcohol will be not an option for us, right? Because we cannot get that strong enough alcohol to dry heat, it's oven. Oven, CDS finally told us what oven, 149 degrees Fahrenheit for 30 minutes. That's you can do for sterilizing to deactivate this virus. Well, if they say 149, just to be sure, they suggest 10 degrees more on the top, 158. I will say 160 degrees Fahrenheit for 30 minutes. But what about elastics? Those masks have elastics, and I believe with the as tailor, I know what destroy elastic, and I know those elastic will be destroyed probably in very few times you throw that mask in the oven. And well, what are the choice of dry heat? Iron? Probably not, because even if you put iron, if you have any iron, even cheap iron these days, come with steaming part of it. Other people will simply not buy it because people want to do steaming and pressing in the same time. And, well, steam always speed up pressing, that's why. But the thing is, even if you put iron settings on no heat at all, I know again that is Taylor, it still will produce, it still will spill some steam. And again, we come into humidity problem, and we cannot have that problem. And also, well, it's a who possible can stay with iron on any piece of filter or any mask for 30 minutes? Not gonna happen. No, well, it kind of oven is not too usable, too wide usable, and iron is not acceptable. No, well, that's why it's still good. We will put plus here for those who are available to do it. Not iron, the oven only. Again, 160 degrees Fahrenheit for 30 minutes. Now we come into steam. And, well, the thing is, what I was confused before, I thought my industrial steamer, which is I used for steaming garments, can kill that virus. It will not. It will not, because, well, what we see is that cloud steam coming out when we boil water, and a lot of suggestions out over there. You boil a pot of water, and you keep your mask over it for 10 minutes, and it's gonna kill virus. No, it will not. Because what we see, what my research is telling me, what we see is that cloud steam, it's not actual steam. It's condensed water vapor. Vapor under pressure become real steam with heat. That heat which is available to sterilize. In medical practice, no less as a 15-18 psi, which is pounds per square inch, for 30 minutes will heat up steam to 121, from 121 to 250 Fahrenheit for sterilization. Industrial steamers for garment usually do not produce that. Yes, some Italian steamer, which is very expensive one, come with 5 bar pressure, which is about 70 psi. It's almost, more is 3 times more is need for sterilization. But again, you have to do it for 30 minutes. And again, it's not the same steam, because maybe it's under pressure, 70 psi, but it still produces that cloud steam, what you can see. It's mean that heat steam, it's you don't see it. It's a steam which is coming out under pressure. You put piece of paper like that under it, and it's scorch paper. It start fire on the paper. None of those steamers will produce that. Industrial steamers for cars, yes, they have them 100 bars pressure and all that. But again, who can, how you can sterilize that with that steamer what you use for steaming for pressure steaming car, how you can sterilize your mask? It will be tearing the parts completely. And again, it's going to be all wet. You're facing again the same problem with humidity, how to dry it properly. And no matter what we're talking about sterilization, look like we're going to face the same problem, which is humidity. And well, does that increase pressure make up for time of sterilizing? For example, if medics tell me what it's only up to 18 psi needed, and my industrial steamer have 70 psi and more, can that pressure, increased pressure, make up for time for steaming? Can be less as half hour because it's more pressure? I don't think so. It's mean, if nobody say nothing about it, I'm not gonna use it. Because how I know what is gonna work? No, well, steam is kind of questionable as well. That's why we put minus here. Now, UV. UV, it's ultraviolet lamps, those. It does kill bacteria, but do nothing, absolutely nothing for this coronavirus. It's already proved by physics, by doctors, don't even go there, because right now online Chinese people sell, everybody sells so much of this UV portable lights, it's gonna sterilize you while you're traveling. Don't go for it, it's all lies, it's do nothing to it. I run across searches which is tell true, what UV doing nothing to it, and it's even do harm, such as it kills that in a filter, particularly that electrostatic precharged, which is help to run ions and work better as filter. It's actually UV actually will kill it. They don't even suggest to dry masks or filters on sun, only on some air going through, but not on the sun. No, well, this is not acceptable. Now boiling. Boiling sounds good to me. I'm old school girl, and boiling sounds really good to me. Yeah, by the way, I forgot to tell about UV. UV can help that lamp if in a completely dark room, look on your mask or filter, probably will show to you stains of that virus on that. That is all it's good for. It's not going to kill it, just to show that. Again, back to boiling. Boiling is good, I believe so. And not just boiling. I'm talking about boiling with water. Why? Don't have to be just boiling. You don't have to throw mask and filter in a completely boiling water and keep on boiling. No, it has to be boiling water to a certain point, and then you add water to it, mixed up, and dip your mask and your filter in it. As long as water higher on temperature as 70 Celsius, which is boiling water definitely higher as that, more as 70 Celsius, again, I repeat, not Fahrenheit, Celsius. In that case, yes, it's proved again by medics, by physicians, it does, by physics, it does kill this coronavirus. No, well, it's good. Why it does? It's the same reason why they tell us to wash our hands as often as possible, because soap molecules have two halves, one fat, one water. And that's why they call it, I hope I pronounce right, amphiphysic. Both hydrophilic and lipophilic. Loves both. Soap loves both. And, well, what it mean? It mean soap binding to water and proteins of virus molecules, tears that virus on apart completely and flush down drain with water. But you have to do it no less than 20 seconds. Again, me being me, I will suggest to do 2 minutes. 2 minutes to put your mask and the filter in all, just after water boiled up, take it off fire. And of course, it has to be completely separate canister for it, not the kitchen, nothing you use in the kitchen. You just boiled up in the kitchen and rest just, or do just with heater steamer outside your door. Don't even bring that virus inside your place. Just put it, you know, those deep in little boiled up heaters. Plug it in somewhere and just boiled up to boiling water. And then after it's done, add soap to it. Practically any soap will do it. Liquid soap, of course, will be more comfortable. And do it generously, I will guess. Because soap does do good for this virus. It does deactivate it in only 20 seconds. Well, and keep it at least for a minute or two. And after that, you can pull it up and rinse. And it has to be rinsed with water. But again, we got to humidity because it will be totally wet. That's why I keep telling you, everyone should have 3 masks. One in sterilization and drying, one you're using, and another one, your extra one. And it has to be, it's hook up on a hanger, hand up, and leave it on some kind of wind going through, but no sun. No, well, this is like my preferred one will be, boiling one. Now, bleach. A lot, you can buy bleach these days, because everybody, it's a whole different story about bleach. Well, everybody get into this bleach sterilizing. Well, I search it. All internet about bleach sterilizing, all way 10 years back in time on internet. And I found out what About 10 years ago, CDS strongly recommended using 10% Clorox solution to wash N95 mask up to 40 times in pandemic on influenza virus. But again, that was for influenza virus. Now, this coronavirus, it's not influenza. It's something different strain of it. And that study following these recommendations was done in New Mexico by not doctors, but physicists, and they found it highly sufficient, was using the ultrasound vaporizer to create micro droppings on the masks and then clean them. And it was very impressive done, very impressive. And again, but corona is not influenza. And now we know, according to studies of American Clinic Institute, I'm shocked how many organizations I never knew they exist. Well, it exists, ACI, American Clinic Institute, and they said what if chlorine, Clorox, if you use Clorox, it's produced chlorine gas or chloramine, I believe it's called. It's created shortness of breath, chest pains, well, practically the same symptoms of what virus caused. And especially if somebody got to mix it with pine salt, vinegar or ammonia, that's what they suggest. And I will stick to boiling. Bleach, I will put minus as well. I hope it's very helpful for you. And I did the same researches, like 3 weeks researches about filters. Tomorrow I'm coming up with another, my improved video about filters, because I found the best filters you can have and you already have it in your possession at home. And I will explain to you why and how I come up to those decisions. I hope see you tomorrow as well. And please subscribe to this channel. And much more videos coming. And Cheryl, I apologize to you. I have one of my subscribers who want me to come up with a no-sewing mask for her situation, because she already on oxygen and she is using those tubes around her ears going. She cannot use any no-sewing mask, which is I have shown to you already those on my channel already, but she cannot use those because of her situation. She already have something on the top of her ears. I'm thinking about it, and very soon I will come up with that, I promise as well. Thank you guys for your time. I hope it's very beneficial to you.